Hey everyone, welcome to the Pangolin Studio. My name is Justin Perry, and today I'm going to be providing you with a brief tutorial video which helps to address one of the most common questions we get from our clients, especially newcomers to the laser industry. And the question is, how do you control multiple projectors using Pangolin software and hardware? So today, in today's tutorial, we're going to address this question and provide you with some real-world examples you can use at home. So let's get started. All right, as you guys can see here, we have two laser projectors and we have one flashback. So what we're going to do in this example is run the ILDA signal from this flashback into our first projector. And then we're going to take a second ILDA cable and run it from the ILDA out on this projector and into our second projector. And now this is possible because this laser projector here has an ILDA input and an ILDA output. And so this configuration we've set up here is commonly referred to as daisy chaining the laser projectors together. And basically, again, you have one FB3 sending a signal to two laser projectors. And that signal first comes here, and then you're connecting a second ILDA cable and sending that signal here. So in a setup like this, what will happen is that since both projectors are receiving the same signal, they're going to produce the same effect. So let's go inside of the QuickShow software and illustrate this with some actual laser output. As we explained earlier, we have two laser projectors, both tied to one FB3QS, and those projectors are daisy chained together. So the first thing I'm going to want to do in this example is go up here to Settings, Projector Settings. And you'll notice that our projector settings is only seeing one projector tied to flashback 61191. So if we go to project our simple test pattern, you'll notice it outputs across both laser projectors, and any adjustments I make in here, such as adjusting size and position, is going to happen across both projectors. So if we, for example, click a cue, you'll notice that that same cue displays across both projectors, and any adjustments we make in our live control area are going to take place across both projectors. And once again, this is because both laser projectors are daisy chained together and they're both receiving one signal from one FB3. So in the first example we showed you earlier, we had both of these projectors daisy chained together. But let's say, for example, your laser projector only has an ILDA input and no ILDA output, as this projector does. Well, in such a scenario, if you want to control both projectors from a single flashback, what you're going to need is an ILDA splitter cable. And you can find these online from any laser show parts store. They're relatively inexpensive. So in this example, what we have is, once again, a single flashback with that signal running into our ILDA splitter cable. We have our first ILDA cable running to projector 1 and a second ILDA cable running to projector 2. And once again, in this example, both projectors are receiving the same signal. They're going to produce the same effect. And we'll illustrate this for you really quickly inside of QuickShow. Okay guys, once again, the first thing we're going to want to do is go to Settings, Projector Settings. Once again, QuickShow is seeing one projector tied to our single flashback 61191. And when we click that test pattern, it's going to produce the same test pattern across both projectors, and any adjustments we make are going to be applied across both projectors. And once again, this is because we have two lasers tied to a single flashback receiving the same signal. Thus, they're going to perform the same effect. Alright guys, in this example we have two laser projectors and now we have two flashbacks. And so what we're going to illustrate is independent control, basically where each laser projector is being controlled by its own FB3. So I'm going to connect projector number 1 to flashback 61191. And then we'll connect projector number 2 to flashback 53911. So here again, we have two laser projectors, each being controlled by their own FB3. So let's go inside a quick show and see what we're able to do with this sort of a setup. Once again, we have two laser projectors here, each being independently controlled by its own flashback. So the first thing we're going to want to do in this example is go to Settings, and we'll select Laser Controller Hardware. And the purpose of this is just to make sure that QuickShow is seeing we have two projectors, each tied to its own flashback. And everything looks good, so we'll click OK. Next thing we'll want to do is go back to Settings, select Projector Settings, and then you'll notice that in this menu right here, QuickShow recognizes that we have two projectors and two flashbacks. So we'll adjust the projector settings for projector number 1. And you can see we'll adjust the size and position. That looks pretty good right about there. And then we'll select projector number 2. And that looks okay right about where it is. So we'll select okay. Next thing we'll do is go back to settings one more time and we'll select our projection zones. And the purposes of this is to tell QuickShow which content we want to display across which projector. So I'm going to select Zone 1, Scanner 1, Main, and I'll project a quick test pattern. And you'll notice by default that is going to Projector 1, Flashback 61191. If we wanted to change that, we could simply pull this drop-down menu and select the other projector, and it would route that zone to the other projector. For the purpose of this example, I'm going to select Zone 8 here, Atmospherics, so I can show you an example where we're using graphics and atmospherics at the same time. So we'll select Zone 8, project a simple test pattern, and you'll see now that we have two zones set up, one for graphics and one for atmospherics, and we have both projectors doing something different, independently controlled from an individual flashback. So we'll click OK. So now if we go into our grid and we select a graphic, you'll notice it's going to projector 1. And if we select an atmospheric effect, you'll notice it goes to projector 2. Now let's say we want to have both projectors doing something different at the same time. We'll select our multi-cue up here. We'll get that graphic going, that atmospheric, and then we'll also get a graphic going here, perhaps the motorcycle. So now you can see we have a graphical image coming from projector 1, an atmospheric from projector 2. Both projectors are doing something different at the same time. So let's say we want to individually control each projector and apply some effects to each of these. No problem. We can come over here into our live control area, and you'll notice by default we have master selected. So any adjustments I make are going to be applied to all projectors. But if I select Q, what you'll notice is that now we have the motorcycle Q selected, and the adjustments that I make will only be done to that specific zone. So we can independently control it. And the same for our other zone, the atmospheric. Any adjustments we make in there will only be done to that specific zone. So this example provides you with an illustration of what we mean by independent control. And there's a lot more things you can do. I was just trying to provide a quick, rough example of what independent control means. But essentially, when each projector is tied to its own flashback, you're going to be able to make these projectors do different things at the same time. And this is what most professionals do because it allows you to create much more complex and creative laser light shows where you have each projector doing different things simultaneously. And these same principles that we just demonstrated for you here with QuickShow also apply to other Pangolin software such as LD2000 and beyond. So I hope that you guys enjoyed this tutorial and found it interesting. We're going to have more tutorial videos like this coming soon. And if you have any questions you'd like us to make a tutorial video on, please send those requests to contact@pangolin.com. One of our goals this year is going to be to create tutorial videos around people's most commonly asked questions. So once again, I hope you enjoyed the tutorial, and we'll see you next time.